Hello, I'm coming to you today from Anvil Analytics and Insights. And today I wanted to talk about and do a quick demonstration on how to group pages together in Google Data Studio. And this is really something that can be done for several different dimensions, but in this example, like I said, we are going to use page views. So, for example, if we want to analyze the performance of maybe our blog pages versus our solutions pages versus all other pages on our site, we can do that. Now, if you just look at the pages or the page dimension in Google Data Studio, it's going to break all of those up. So it's going to be very hard to really compare each one of those groups to each other. What we can do though is go into Resources, Manage Added Data Sets. We can click Edit here. Make sure it's blue. If it's not blue, you don't have the required permissions in order to go in and do this. But what we can do is come down here and add a field. We're going to give the field a name, so we'll do page groupings, blog solutions, other. Now, in the formula, we can go down here. I've already created this formula. Basically, what you're going to do is create a case statement. So, for each one of your lines, you're going to do contains text. All of our blog pages contain backslash blog in the URL. So for any one of those pages, we're going to tell the system to return blog post page. And that's what we can see then in our table. Then for our solutions pages, we're going to do the exact same thing with backslash solutions, backslash. If that's in the URL, we're going to spit out solutions pages. If it's anything else here, we're just going to use the else other. And then we'll go ahead and end that. If you have the green check mark down here at the bottom, that is how you know that formula is good and set and you're ready to roll. From there, you can go ahead and click Save. And then once it's saved, you can click Done and close out. Here, you're going to go add that custom field that you just created, just like you would add anything else. So we have page groupings. And then honestly, we can get rid of this extra page one that we have here. But you can see exactly how many blog page or blog post page views we had in total, how many solutions pages we had in total, etc. Now, we use this a lot because we have a lot of healthcare companies. And so, for some of their forms on their site, they may have a different form for each one of their specialties. Well, in Google Analytics, we don't want to create a different goal for each one of those specialties because there's more than 20 and we'll run out of goals. So, what we do a lot of times is capture all those as one goal and then we break those out based on the destination pages in Google Data Studio. So, you can see how many people apply for each one of those different specialties. So, I hope this helps. I hope you can use this in your analytics and your dashboard processes that you guys have created. If so, and you want to continue receiving tips and tricks from us, make sure you go to our website and subscribe to our newsletter and give us a like down at the bottom.